So, I managed to complete the first mission. I got paid. I didn't get any bonuses. Had a lot of expenses. I have ammunition costs. Overall income. Now here's the problem with this game.
Coral, a sublime substance. Discovered on Rubicon, a planet on the frontier of developed space. For a time, coral was a revolutionary energy resource and data conduit, poised to transform human society by leaps and bounds.
You named it coral?
They called it the Fires of Ibis, a storm of flame that tore through the stars, leaving lethal contamination in its wake.
I don't know who wrote this, but they're dumb.
The kindling was thought to have been utterly consumed, forever lost.
Really, really dumb.
However, on Rubicon, the embers continued to burn. Humanity would inevitably return.
They should have named it something other than coral.
The fire.
Coral, as in the sea creature. Yeah. Dead exoskeletons of creatures makes reefs.
Registration number RB23. Call sign Raven. Authentication complete. Removing MIA status. Restoring access privileges. This is Allmind, the mercenary support system. Welcome back, Raven.
The authentication. Raven. That's who you are now, here on Rubicon. I've picked up some work for you already. Take a look, 621.
This notification follows restoral of access privileges. Allmind provides a combat training simulator to support its mercenaries. Your license was in a suspended state. Perhaps you may need a refresher. As an added incentive, completion of the exercises will be rewarded with AC parts. You stand to benefit regardless.
Wondering how they were gonna do that. This AC design. I hate the fact that I have to bounce back and forth between my keyboard and my controller. I hate the fact that every time I enter a new thing, it's like, well now, this is a bunch of bullshit. Bullshit! Main color. And they use RGB values to generate colors, which, if you're me, it's gonna be black. Thank you. go on the first training mission now that we played with the image editor. Yeah, sorry I got quiet there. The image editing thing always kind of throws me off because, like, sometimes it works really well, sometimes it works really shitty. This one it works really well, but the game's combat is kind of eh. The fact that it is making me bounce back and forth between keyboard and mouse and controller so much is kind of ticking me off. I'll probably cut this into multiple, well, yeah, you'll see when it comes out. I really hate the fact that I'm having to use both keyboard and mouse to do anything whenever I should just be able to do it all from a controller. Because you know on the Xbox... you should have started off with to begin with. It doesn't tell you this, but in order to get past those little tab things when you're using a controller, you need to use the start button. Yeah, that's a useful feature to know, right? Totally get it. This is what they should have started off with as a tutorial at the beginning of the game before you launch your mission. Then you should have had your ability to actively tool out your mech to what you think your best fighting options are based on how well you do in this crap. Not just drop you in as a drop pod and then say, oh, look. You don't know anything, so here you go. Even though you're a mech pilot. Energy blade cycling should also be something that's a fast. There's got to be a better version of it somewhere that you ain't got. V to scan. Okay, so how do I do that in the controller? Repair, purge, weapon, L, R for option, scan is down. You see, they don't actually give you any of the... Man, this is retarded. All the cues are based off of... So here's what I figured out based off of this. This is what's currently equipped. It's got the EQ in the window. That's easy to see, right? I hope you guys can see it on the video. So the unequipped head is this one here. You can see the comparison based on the numbers. This one is less weight than the original one, than this one up here. It has a faster system recovery. This one does. Attitude stabilization. The other one is better at that because it has the fin system in it. And AP armor points. It is way heavily armored. Better so than the other one is. So why am I going with this one? Well, to be honest, wait. I'm trying to get the thing to respond faster, and the easiest way to do that is to change out the shit that you're carrying. Let's see. This arm here has my pulse blade in it, which is kind of crap. And this arm here has my gun in it, which is currently the tuner, which is the one that I started off with. Notice the attack power on this one is less, impact is less. Total rounds 540, total rounds 540, impact 65, 85. So why am I going to go for the lesser gun? Because I want the fire rate. Is exactly why. Because I kind of hate the fire rate currently the gun that I have. But I'm going to test it first. Again. Because I want to make sure that I know how it's going to handle before I go out and do something stupid like run a complete mission. Thank you. energy blade works. Said before, this is me trying to figure out how fast the damn gun goes. Better target lock than just a jump lock on those things with this missile pod that I've currently got access to. Kinda crappy. Not gonna lie. Scanning would have been nice to know earlier whenever you were actually, you know, actively fighting things that needed to be scanned. So again, nothing new, just training. Well, let's go for a sortie, shall we? What kind of missions have we got? Alright. Destroy artillery installation. That's always fun. You know what? Let's go with that one. What the hell? I'm gonna run this one mission.
Got a job for you, 621. This is an open call from the Balaam Group, one of the corporate forces occupying Rubicon.
Attention all independent mercenaries! This request comes from our affiliate, Dafung. The Rubicon Liberation Front has deployed Baus artillery throughout the contaminated city. The city itself has no strategic value, but we cannot allow them to hinder expansion of the Coral Survey. Show us your
the
ambition.
The fact that they called it Coral.
Destroy the Liberation Front's
me.
Artillery.
Floors me to no end.
Will be awarded for destroying
they couldn't
their
have
MTs.
Created something whole cloth from scratch. Unobtainium is better than that.
Consider
Jesus
it an opportunity
Christ.
To prove yourself. Impress us, mercenaries!
Coral! Coral, because we don't have it in our own oceans anymore! Let's just check. check something real quick. Do I have anything as a back part right now? Just that. Okay. Let's go, what the hell? Let's see how it goes. Maybe I'll die, maybe I'll win.
The client doesn't care who does this job. As long as it gets done.
Sad part is, I really like these games. They're like my favorite thing that I remember from the PlayStation. I spent as many times playing this as I did playing like Tomb Raider and all those kind of games. And Tenchu. I don't know if you know what Tenchu is, but Tenchu is a stealth ninja game, which came out around the same time that the Metal Gear Solid franchise really took off. The first game came out against it, and in my opinion, was a 1,000 times better game than it was, because it actually had real stealth combat and kills in it, and it had martial artists and things like that doing the combat moves for it. I do not understand how. They managed to make Metal Gear Solid into what it is, and people love it so much because I personally find it redundant. But maybe that's just me.
What kind of corporate merc? They're all to us already. Sneaky bastard.
This is kind of what Gundam players, which is Gundam, was like. Run in, do some stuff, kill some stuff.
There. That's one of the artillery placements. The front is protected with armor plating. Attack it from behind.
Deploy for combat. Destroy that AC.
There's only one of them. We can do this.
Let's double check and make sure we didn't miss anything, just to be on the safe side. I don't like getting caught by stupidity, which is what usually happens.
You're up against mass-produced MTs. Eliminate them as necessary.
Enemy attack! They're after the artillery! Fight back!
Head to the final site. Keep up the good work.
Because although this game isn't bad, it isn't really good either.
There! That culprit's dog! Don't give him another inch! We have to defend the artillery!
Set. said.
Remaining. Right hand ammunition at 50%.
Notification from Allmind, the mercenary support system. Registration number RB23, call sign Raven. Your return to mercenary activities has been acknowledged. Restoring access to the parts shop.
Good.